medium sales tax vote losing big tonight in Kansas City, Missouri, and in Jackson County. Let's go to KNBC 9's Jackson Kurtz. I believe you have the county executive, Frank White, with you.
Yes, sir. I'm here with County Exec Frank White. Mr. White, how do we feel about tonight's results?
I feel good about it. I think it's about doing what's right. And I think you hear the noise in the background. All these folks here in the crossroads, they just want to do what's right. They just want a better deal. They want a more equitable deal. They want the teams at the table negotiating a beneficial agreement that's going to benefit the county itself.
You want the teams to stay in Jackson County.
Yeah, the intent is not to have any team leave. The intent is just to come up with a deal that's going to be good for everybody. I know that having this on the ballot with no agreement kind of put the taxpayers in jeopardy. I think now it gives us a chance to reset, and hopefully the teams will take a deep breath, come back to the table, and we can work out something that's equitable for everyone.
You know, and going forward, the talk's been just how both sides can meet to get a deal done. What can make this process go faster this time around rather than this long haul that we had here with this tax in the stadium?
I think what needs to happen is to get the right people at the table, get the auxiliary folks out of the way, know who you're dealing with, sit down, do the deal, and keep moving. I think that there's been a love for these teams for a long time from the taxpayers of Jackson County, and I think that they deserve more than just to say, if you don't pass this tax, we're going to leave. And with 7 years left on the lease, that makes it even sound worse. So people don't like to be threatened for their money, and I think now that the people have spoken, hopefully, like I say, everybody can take a deep breath, understand where we were, understand where we're trying to go, and get to the table and work out a deal that's best for the county, the citizens, and for the teams themselves.
What do you think this vote says about folks in Jackson County and Kansas City?
Well, I think it really shows that you can't take us for granted. I think that when you're looking at two teams that are heavily taxpayer-funded, and I think people feel like they love their teams, they've supported their teams in good times, bad times, and I think that just to come out of the blue with a rush thing on the April ballot and say, well, if you don't pass this thing, we're leaving, are we going to explore our options, then it's almost like a punch in the gut, you know, because people are saying, well, we love them. We've shown them how much we love them, but where's that love in return?
What's next?
Back to the table, hopefully. That's my goal, is to make sure that we keep our teams, make sure that the fans can still enjoy our sports teams, make sure that we can get an agreement, because you can't have a team getting public financing without a legitimate agreement on the table that's been negotiated back and forth across the table. And that's what we don't have right now.
All right, Mr. White, thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.